had her nursed back to health, then sent her on her way to Novigrad.
Take it easy. Surface here, dig their way out. Thank you. Take it easy. Slow now. Not so fast, Roach. Come on. Slower.
Very good.
Bye.
Come closer. Don't be shy.
You call this
You'll
living,
find
which
everything
I
think ever need.
Thank you.
city.
Ow!
Huh? Jump at the most.
Don't spare a couple or two.
Why does the range of goods around?
Just looking at the boss.
With the bastard. Why, it's widely known how anybody who packs with Wiley ends.
Siri was desperate, but you're right. Wasn't the best idea. Orson ended up wounding Siri just after he'd tortured Dudu.
Dudu? Well, how is Dudu related to this in any way?
Seems Dandelion got him involved to help Siri. Luckily, Dudu managed to escape, probably hiding somewhere now.
What of Wiley?
I'd expect him to lay low, not do any business for some time.
Certainly hope you're right. Though his type never forgives and rarely relents.
not sure.
Show me what you have in stock. So long.
Not sword.
Willing to craft something for me? Show me what you have in stock. So long.
I'm watching you.
do. What do you want?
Ever play Gwent?
I do. Gwent's like politics, just more honest. Care for a game against an old master?
Yeah, let's play.
Don't have Esterhad Tyson in your deck. Here, he's yours.
Thanks. Know anyone else I could win some cards off of?
I know an elf you might try. Got an excellent card in his deck. You'll find him beyond the city walls, where the Scuyatel stragglers have their shanty town. do. What do you want?
You were going to show me something.
Mm-hmm. And you were going to follow. Come on, no mucking around this time. Understood? Zerikania. Won him. Card game with a camel merchant.
Your jokes are getting better by the minute.
See me smiling? I'm dead serious.
But I bumpy horses. Hot there. Siggy bad take. Good Siggy.
Don't seem to have trouble communicating with the troll. Why'd you bring me down here?
Take note of that hole. We'll come back to it later. And see that door? Vault behind it, until recently filled with Novigrad crowns and countless other valuables.
But God! Then boom! Chorfun, go!
Translating into common, someone fucking made off with nearly 20 tons of my gold and all the lighter stuff. And you will help me get it back.
Why don't you handle this? Gotta have connections in the underworld. What do you need a witcher for?
The gold wasn't mine alone. See, I run a members-only savings club, a bank for the initiated. For reasons that should be obvious, I prefer it if my temporary liquidity problems remained private. So I need an outsider.
How do you know you can trust me?
I don't. Counting on your survival instinct. Slip up, and I'll kill you. Feed you to Bart.
Bart, sorry. Bart job that good.
Fine. I'll help you.
You're not exactly bursting with enthusiasm.
Witcher mutations. They strip us of emotion. I'd be jumping for joy otherwise. All right. Ought to look around. But first, some questions.
I'm all ears.
How much was it all worth? Got an approximate idea?
Why the fuck do you care? Figuring your finder's fee. Don't get your hopes up.
Know you too well for that. Just prefer to know what I'm looking for.
3 crates of Nilfgaardian florins, a chest of emeralds, rubies and topazes, silver candlesticks and platters. I could go on.
Shiny Jorfun. Oh, God.
Anyone see what happened?
Other than Bart? No. And the vault's location is known only to the treasure's co-owners. Well, and the thieves.
What about upstairs? Anything unusual happened in the bathhouse the day of the break-in?
No. Happen swears it was calm as ever. The usual customers, no incidents. Bloody bucolic.
Take it the thieves got in through the hole behind you.
You're a regular fucking master sleuth. Any other brilliant deductions you want confirmed? The year, maybe? Bloody name of Redania's king?
No, but I am wondering, for instance, how that hole got there.
Hole, no. Boom. Hole. Bad look, won't go. Bad look, no. Only sleep. Bad shoes. Head falling.
Boom. Can you elaborate?
Boom. Big. This like.
I'll elaborate. Explosion. Big enough to blow that fucking hole in the wall, separating the vault from the sewers.
Gotten pretty good at communicating with this troll.
Lots of prior experience. Worked with idiots my whole life.
Bad mushrooms? What's that about?
Pops mold. The spores are highly toxic. One whiff and you're dead. Unless you're a troll, that is.
Yes. Bad. Bad. Troll.
Not talking to you, dimwit. Where was I? Ah, mold spores. They cover the walls of the sewers other side of the vault. Actually thought it was a good thing, you know? A bit of extra protection. Thieves found a way through it.
Bart, you see them?
Bart, through hole. Once see, boom, got what? Breathe, shroom. Sleep, go. Jorfun, gone. Bad troll.
Now, now. Stiff upper lip.
Try to track down the thief yourself?
Of course. Hired this lummox, Fonz. Thick enough not to ask questions. We knocked back some Pop's antidote and entered the sewers. Soon after, I returned alone.
What happened?
Lad started belching something horrendous. I mean, burps with so much mass the walls shook. Told him, Fonz, stop. You're in the presence of a count. Well, former count, but still. And then he puked up. Up came most of the antidote. Lost his protection. Tried to pull him out. Then I heard a bubbling. Something crawled out of the water. I value the lives of my men, I do. But I value my own even more. Dropped Fonz and ran like hell.
Mind describing this something that crawled out of the water?
No. Doesn't mean I can, though. Air in the sewer's thick with spores. Can hardly see a thing down there.
Must have noticed something. Was it...
No! Didn't notice a fucking thing. Didn't do a taxonomic field analysis either. I know it's an inconvenience to you, but I felt I should get the hell out of there as fast as I could.
Should look around the sewers. Got any more of that Pop's antidote?
Have a few vials left. Got the formula too. Disgusting swill, to be honest, but it'll save your life. Here.
Thanks.
You've naught to thank me for, literally. You're no good to me if you suffocate. Listen, I'll be upstairs if you need me. Sight of this empty vault's giving me an ulcer. Good luck to you.
Dandelion, what the hell have you gotten yourself into? Edges curled out. Something inside blew it wide open. Wall too. Bathhouse drain pipes seem to converge here. Great. Explosion crumpled it like a piece of paper. And there's mortar on the bars. So it was in place at the time of the explosion. Blast tore it from the wall. No traces of magic. This was no spell. It was a bomb. Now why am I not finding pieces of it? Could be the current swept them away.
Getting harder to breathe.
bottom of a container. Silver cylinder, most likely. Runes etched in the bottom. It's warped, probably by the explosion. Bomb part. Must be. Smells like wyvern oil and caramel. That'd be it down here. Time to see Dijkstra. Otherwise, Draenors will never stop congregating. Another trinket.
Nice!
One more time, can we talk?
Siggy, you like. Talk me with.
Anything suspicious happened before the robbery?
Suspicious. But no understand.
Something not normal. Something strange. Maybe you saw, felt, heard something?
Yeah. But here. His.
The hissing. Where did it come from?
But his here. In love tree.
What?
Where Bart turned it up.
What kind of hissing was it? Like a snake?
No. A piece odder. Not animal all act.
Right. So, like what?
Like... rock?
A hissing rock. Mm-hmm. All right. Let's change the subject.
Good. But time got. Chorfun go. But God now nothing.
Why do you like Siggy so much?
Siggy good. Siggy can't take part.
He locked you up, alone, underground. Don't get bored down here. Not much to do.
When Bart, not much do. Bart, think. Lots.
What about, if you don't mind my asking?
Rocks.
Rocks.
Rocks, interesting.
Thanks for your help. So long.
Long.
do you want?
Done. Examined every nook of the sewers near your vault.
Well, learn anything?
Bits of treasure dropped out of the crates, left a clear trail. You know, like the fairy tale, with the crumbs.
Another one. Hansel, Gretel, burning witches. Very fitting for Novigrad.
Trail leads to the river where the sewer lets out. Breaks off there. My bet, they loaded the treasure onto a boat.
Yeah, a cart drawn by sewer rats does seem unlikely. And since boats don't leave trails, it amounts to fuck all.
Found a second corpse, one of the thieves. Threw up the antidote just like your man Fonts.
A beautiful death. Anything on the body?
Not much. Empty vial.
Wouldn't have left him behind if he was anybody. Common porter, must be. Knew nothing, means nothing. Dead end, literally.
Seems to me a bomb blew the wall open. Look.
Bottom of a silver cylinder, probably. Covered in runes. Interesting. Any idea what it contained?
Recognized some ingredients by their scent. Wyvern oil and sugar.
Sugar? Geralt, I'm in no mood for jests.
Nor am I. Just saying what I found. Bomb contained sugar.
Let's think. Sugar would react violently with sulfuric acid. Not so violently to cause an explosion.
Didn't know you were versed in alchemy.
Dabbled in it a bit while at Oxenford Academy. But this is no time to reminisce. You're to find my treasure, not write my biography. Know anything else about this bomb? Anything at all?
Bomb went off inside a drainage pipe embedded in the vault wall. But the grate at the end of the pipe was in place when the blast happened, meaning...
The bomb must have found its way into the pipe from inside the bathhouse.
Exactly. Might have gone something like this. Perpetrator started emptying one of the pools, then dropped the bomb down the drain.
The bomb flowed down with a runoff, came to rest on the grate, and, to quote Bart, big boom.
Drain pipes are only promising lead. We just need to know which pool it's connected to.
Yes. Appen keeps a record of guests. Should be able to tell us who used that pool the day of the break-in. You've not done badly.
Feel honored to be acknowledged.
Oh, that famous sarcasm. I missed it.
Really?
About as much as I'd miss a knife in my knickers. All right. You inspect the pools on the right, I'll take the ones on the left. Holler if you find anything.
Nothing interesting here. Something floating on the surface. Oil, looks like. Silver lid. Matches the cylinder bottom I found in the sewer. Dijkstra, come here.
Got something?
Yeah, bomb part.
Happen! Drain pool 4, and bring me the guest book. Chop, chop.
By the way, what about Happen? Could have overheard you mention the vault. Has access to the bathhouse whenever he wants.
Happen has numerous flaws. He's pompous, pretentious, can be a real prick sometimes, ironic as that may sound. But his loyalty is beyond question.
How can you be so sure?
Witches know their monsters. Spies know their men.
You trusted Philippa Eilhart once, too.
True. But I didn't pull Philippa Eilhart out of a Kaveri prison the night before her execution.
Let's see what's on the bottom. Grate's been removed from the drain, meaning they flushed the bomb down here.
Happen? Who used this pool the day of the break-in?
Let me see. Bertel Heinz, town councilman, Josef Schweik, brewer, and Margrave Henkel.
Henkel? That's impossible.
Impossible? Why?
Old Coot's been eating dirt since last winter. Couldn't have been here the day of the break-in.
He's dead? I've not heard.
Not surprising. The Honourable Margrave croaked in a brothel, decked out in leather lingerie, so the family held a hush-hush funeral. But I have my sources.
Yeah, I saw him that fateful day, Mr. Reuven. I'm certain of it.
Did you speak to him? Get a good look at him?
No. He merely passed by on the way in.
So you didn't see Henkel? You saw an impersonator? Think for once. They scooped out your balls, not your brain. And you, Geralt, start looking into this.
Should I start?
Henkel's home. Derelict townhouse south of the main square. You might happen on some trace of this scoundrel we're looking for there. Well, off with you.
Graves townhouse. Dandelion made some interesting friends.
silver cylinder. Bottom looks like what I found in the sewer. Absolutely excellent. Startling bouquet. You absolutely must try it. But afterwards, please place the bottle back where you found it. Your birth year. Could be dandelions or Ceres. Satisfying click. In the next room over, I think.
Decided we could use someone who knows a bit of magic. The runes on the bomb, I'm absolutely dying to know what they mean.
You dying to know too, Triss?
No, just here for the coin.
Ah, Marigold playing the cynical materialist. I love it. In truth, her ideals brought Triss here. She needs gold to save her colleagues. When I recover my treasure, I'll be in a position to help her. Simple as that. Speaking of which, and pardon my Beauchlairoise, have you found out who fucking nicked my gold?
Hang on. Gotta tell me why you're here first. We agreed. If I learned anything, I'd take it to you.
So we did. But I was concerned about you. Stop by to see if everything was all right.
Thanks. You can breathe easy now. In the future, though, remember this. I can look after myself.
Fine. You look after yourself, and I'll look after my interests.
Gentlemen, really feel privileged to witness your battle of wits. But try to remember, unlike you, I put my life at risk every time I venture out into the streets. Did the same just coming here. So I beg you, can we get to the point?
Bothered Triss for nothing. No point examining the bomb.
Because?
Because I already know who nabbed your treasure. Commander of the Temple Guard, Caleb Menger.
Well, well, Merigo. Your coin stands to come with a side of revenge. Geralt, would you be kind enough to tell me what you've learned? I'm terribly curious.
Henkel told me. Old man's alive and well. Faked his own death to escape his creditors.
Strange. I had no idea he was in debt.
He was. And Menger promised to take care of things in exchange for help with the heist, so...
Geralt, how can I put this delicately? Bollocks. If you thought I'd fall for that tale you just pulled out of your arse, you don't know me one bit.
Know you well enough to know what matters. Results. So I lied. Still say I can lead you to your treasure.
Forgive me, Geralt. But after what you just pulled, I'd sooner believe a whore who proclaimed her undying love.
Would you believe a sorceress who stands to gain if you get your coin back?
Perhaps. I'd still prefer the whore, though. You're hiding something. And that's one thing I can't stand. Even more than Nilfgaard. But ultimately, this is a business deal, not a marriage. Besides, there must be some truth in all those lies. You're too dense to make it all up on your own. Menger has been spending heaps of coin lately, though to my knowledge he shouldn't have a copper to his name.
So, what now?
From what I've heard, Menger spends his nights at the docks, Witch Hunter's quarters. Maybe pay him a visit, ask where he's holding my gold for me.
So we do your dirty work while you sit around twiddling your thumbs.
Darling, when I'm able to make use of someone, I always do. It's convenient.
And safe. Come on, admit you're scared of Menger.
Of course I'm scared. Bloody dangerous horse, son. Triss would concur, I think.
Not in those words. But I do agree with the statement overall.
Doubt Menger will admit anything willingly.
As do I. Lucky I hired a witcher and a sorceress who've been through so much together to get this done.
What's our past got to do with it?
A great deal. Lovers will jump into the abyss for one another. Suits my needs perfectly. Namely, it greatly increases your chances of getting out of the hunter's barracks alive. With my treasure.
Information's out of date. We are not.
Yes, I know. You parted a week after the summit of Loch Muin, in the woods near where the Lixella flows into the Pontar. But you know what they say. Old love never dies.
First love. Now how the hell...
That's my secret, lovebirds. Really must be going. Good luck.
Didn't have to disagree so strongly.
Put yourself in my shoes. What would you have said?
In your shoes, I wouldn't be worrying about what I say to Dijkstra. At all. But we've strayed from our topic. Got a treasure to recover.
Triss, gotta tell you something. Dijkstra's gold, it's the last thing I care about.
Thought as much. This is about Ciri, isn't it?
Menger's got Dandelion locked up somewhere. and Dandelion saw Ciri.
That changes everything. Listen, meet me at midnight by the Chapel of the Eternal Fire, east of the harbor. We'll figure out a way to get into the Hunter's Barracks together.
All right, see you then. And thanks.
Glad you're here. Listen, took a look at the building and it does not look good.
Mean it could use a bit of paint and spackle?
I mean, it's a damn fortress. High walls, guards at the gate, armed men everywhere. We could never sneak in, and fighting our way in won't work. Menga would have had plenty of time to escape.
What do you suggest?
Take these shackles. Put them on me.
Mind explaining what this is all about?
Think. Bring the hunters the vial Triss Marigold. They won't just open the gate for you. They're likely to let you present her to Menga personally.
No way. Too risky.
Dandelion's life's on the line. Ciri's too. No such thing as too risky.
Triss, think about it. Really want to walk into the lion's den of your own free will? And in chains?
Yes.
No, can't allow it.
Nice of you to worry, but I've made my decision, and I won't change it.
Fine. Let's say they take the bait. What then? We go in, I put a sword to Menga's throat and ask him where Dandelion is?
Might not work. Menga's scum, but you have to admit, death doesn't scare him.
Always found that annoying in fanatics. So we gotta trick him into talking. Any ideas?
Maybe tell him you have information about the Lodge. Or about Philippa. Even better, he hates her most of all. You'll think of something.
What about the treasure?
If we learn anything, great. If not...
Thought you need coin from Dijkstra to help the other mages.
True, I do. Lots of ways to get gold, though. It's just not the most important thing now.
Wait. I want to thank you.
Come on. Anyone would do this.
No. Not anyone.
Stop. It doesn't befit a sorceress to blush.
Still got a bad feeling about this. But tough. Let's go.
Geralt, remember, I can take care of myself.
What are you talking about?
The hunters. They won't treat me like a lady, but I'll survive. Might hurt a bit, but... Ciri, she's what matters. Do what you need to do, no matter what happens.
Can't promise that.
I'm still asking you to, all right?
All right.
What do you want?
Here for my reward.
What the hell for?
For a witch. Recognize who I got? It's Triss Marigold.
Marigold? Come in then.
Well, well. Triss Marigold. Giving up drowners for sorceresses.
Pays better.
It's cause they do more harm. What's a drowner do? Pull the odd fisherman from his boat. But the witches, they murder kings, scheme, start wars.
Don't forget turning your cow's milk sour straight out of the udder.
You're done jesting, Marigold. For good. Put her in a cell.
Not so fast. I hand her over to Menga himself, or not at all.
You reckon we don't know what to do with this witch?
Let go, you bastard!
Vulgar tongue's got no place being in such a pretty mouth. I guess we'll have to rip it out.
Try to loosen it if I were you. Might learn something interesting.
For instance...
For instance, where Philippa Isleheart's hiding.
I'll get you for this, you...
Shut your gob, Ginger Whore, and you spit it out. Where's Isleheart?
Don't talk to her that way.
Why not? She's a whore, isn't she?
Maybe, but for now she's my whore, and I say you can't insult her.
Funny you feel that way, but so be it. Now, Philippa, talk.
Thought I made myself clear. I'll only talk to Menga.
Menga don't talk to the likes of you.
Well, then you be sure to tell him I came by with my friend Marigold.
Fine, grab her and come with me. But be sure to stay right close.
Split up. Go see Menga. Marigold will be next door.
You can't have her until I get...
You don't set the terms here. Dirk, you know what to do.
You won't get a word out of me. Not you, not him.
Oh, playing tough, eh? Just you wait. We'll take a fingernail or three. That ought to get you singing.
Fine, take her. I'd rather she didn't interrupt my conversation. But hands off, don't touch her.
Why? Feel sorry for the bitch.
No, couldn't give a shit about her. But if I don't get what I want from Menga, I'll want to sell her to someone else. Don't want you damaging the goods.
Keen nose for enterprise. You'd make a great madam.
Don't you worry. Mengr will give you your coin, and Marigold will get what she deserves.
Do what you want.
Come on, witch. Show you the wonders a pair of pliers can work. You'd be surprised.
I believe I told you not to let anyone in.
Unless they had information concerning Philippa Isleheart. This witcher says he's got just that.
Anyone can climb that.
We'll start with your pinky nail. Nah, let's go for your ring finger. This little piggy went to market.
But it's not that easy to bring us Triss Merigold.
Is that who I hear? Very well. I'll go see her shortly. But first, let us talk. Sit. Have a drink, Witcher.
Sidarian.
A 1261 vintage, year of the massacre of Sintra.
Stop squirming! This little piggy went home!
Kurt, please see why Miss Merigold squeals so convincingly. Perhaps she needs something. Hot irons, for instance.
Speaking of metal, this goblet's silver. Making sure I'm not a Doppler.
Ah, it's immediately apparent. A professional. I find that refreshing. But to answer your question, one can never be too careful. You'd be surprised how many come here turn to rancid jelly as soon as they grip the goblet.
No way around this?
Of course there is. Dopplers also assume their true form when subjected to horrific pain. So I could have you flogged. Effective, true, but the goblin method is much quicker. Now, let us get down to business.
See, you're an expert on Dopplers.
I'd expect a witcher of all things to understand the value of knowing one's enemy.
This little piggy had roast beef. This little piggy had none.
Now, let us talk shop. I shall pay you twice the usual reward for Merigold.
Awfully generous. Why?
Well, you've turned in your lover. The emotional trauma it must entail. You deserve compensation.
What does it matter if you're paying gold for her head?
Oh, yeah. Nearly forgot the mutation strip witches of feelings.
No. No more.
Be brave, dear. Just one more fingernail and we'll move on to the other hand. This little piggy went wee, wee, wee. Ow! Bitch bit me.
Ah, the bitch bites. Let's put a collar on it. Dimeritium ought to calm her down.
You surprise me, Geralt. Perhaps we can deal after all. So, you know something about Philippa.
But I wager you won't share this information for free. What do you want in return?
Know what? Fuck you. Had enough of this masquerade.
Guards! In here!
That's all of them. That was close. What happened? I thought Menga took the bait.
No, he didn't. Sensed right off it was all a front.
We should search the office. Maybe we can find some documents mentioning Dandelion. I'll search his body. You search the room. I'd start with the desk. In his pockets. Here. Nothing under his belt. Wait, something's sewn in the lining.
What is it?
The key to a vault. Here, give it to Dijkstra with my regards.
I found a letter to Menga from someone important. A spy, I think.
A spy?
Take a look.
Drop boxes. Secret signals. Yeah. Strong stench of spycraft here. This agent could know more about Dandelion.
Bet he does. Letter explains how to signal for a meeting. No mention of where it would take place.
Maybe Dijkstra can help. He knows everything.
Everything? Slight exaggeration there.
I'm not so sure.
Key to a vault? No address? Why do I doubt this'll make Dijkstra smile?
Well, might keep him from setting his thugs on us. Breaking our legs for failing to fulfill our part of the bargain.
Meaning glass is half full?
Of something strong, I hope.
All right. Nothing left for us here. Let's go.
Be glad to. Just not by way of the main gate. This is where we split up. But first, let's burn this shack down.
Agreed. We've left too much evidence.
Yeah, but I also need to blow off some steam. Listen, there's one other thing I wanted to talk about. But not here, and definitely not now. Come by later when you have a moment. I'd appreciate it. All right, we need to get out of here.
Mr. Reuven, what's the word?
Impatient old bastard.
What?
Nothing. Be there soon.
Who do I spy? Why, it's Geralt of Rivia.
Will you stop following me already?
I will, as soon as you tell me where my treasure is.
Me and Menga didn't see eye to eye.
How badly?
Badly.
I suppose that explains the smoke. My treasure's not in there, is it? Burning with the witch hunters.
Didn't see it anywhere, and 20 tons of gold is hard to miss.
You mean to say you've come to me empty-handed?
First off, you came to me. Second, I do have something in my hand. The key to a vault, founded on Menga.
A vault that I need to find on my own. You've not made things much easier for me. Give me that.
That's all you're gonna say? No wry remark, no scintillating joke.
You want a knee slapper? Fine, I'll tell you one. Ready? You lied to me. Again.
What?
You knew from the start who robbed me, but you didn't deign to share that information with me.
No, I didn't. But I did deign to help you find your treasure, so stop moaning.
I jest you not, Geralt. You abused my trust.
I can live with that.
This time, yes, you'll live. And now, time to settle things.
That a threat?
Quite the contrary. You helped me, Witcher. So in spite of everything, you've earned your reward. I take it you've still no idea what happened to Dandelion?
None. Found someone who might know, though. A spy, I guess. Signs his name, Yammerlack. Found a letter of his. Just one problem. It only details how to arrange a meeting with him. Makes no mention of where.
A ruined house in Far Corners. Give the signal, and he'll show up there the same day, just before midnight.
Thanks for your help.
No need to thank me. Just paying off a debt. I always do, you know. Even to liars. And a final humble plea. Don't try to fool me again. Ever.